Exposing David Wood. Of Mosques and Men, David Wood is a Christian apologist who attempts to save Muslim souls through his organization Act 17 Apologetics and www.answeringmuslims.com. In the past, Wood and his entourage, including Nabil Qureshi, have targeted the Dearborn Arab Festival in Michigan for proselytism. At the 2009 Arab Festival, David Wood made a controversial, and some claim one-sided video that received over a million hits on YouTube, which showed them getting kicked out of the festival. They claim that they were just engaged in free speech, whereas security at the festival stated that they were insulting and harassing festival goers. Other evangelical Christians criticized Wood and his group as being agitators. The Reverend Haytham Abi Haydar, a Christian evangelical convert from Islam with Arabic Alliance Church in Dearborn, said that a Christian group called Act 17 Apologetics caused the problems at this year's Arab Festival. They put cameras in their faces and were very antagonistic, Abi Haydar said of the group that produced the controversial video that has drawn almost 1.4 million views on YouTube. Just recently at the 2010 Dearborn Arab Festival, David Wood, Nabil Qureshi and two others were arrested for disorderly conduct. Obviously intending to make a scene in an attempt at more YouTube success by portraying themselves as being persecuted. Now David Wood, whose love of Muslims seems to be akin to Pamela Geller's, who he links to favorably a number of times, is joining arms with the anti-Muslim hate group SIOA in opposing the mosque and cultural center that is to be built a few blocks away from Ground Zero. In the following video, filled with disinformation, falsehood and inaccuracies, he expounds his reasons as to why he is against the mosque, and why he sees Muslims as a lurking evil attempting to take over the West. We expose it all in this series. Of Mosques and Men. 10 years later, two groups of Muslims, the Cordoba Initiative and the American Society for Muslim Advancement, are planning to build a massive 13-story mosque right here behind me. Right off the bat, we see the disinformation at work. This isn't a 13-story mosque. Why would Muslims need 13 stories to pray in the middle of Manhattan? The fact is, this is a cultural center that, alongside space for a mosque, will contain a theater, swimming pool, restaurant, and other facilities with the expressed goals of promoting tolerance and mutual cooperation between people of different and varying backgrounds. Understandably, many people here in the West are concerned. What the fuck? Many people in the West are concerned. I highly doubt the masses of people in Europe or Canada really care about this particular Islamophobia-driven agitation, unless that many people he is referring to is the small hate group SIOE, Stop the Islamization of Europe, and parent organization of SIOA, whose main campaigns revolve around opposing mosques and other anti-Muslim initiatives. This isn't an attempt to honor the victims of 9/11 instead, it may be an attempt to build a symbol of Islamic victory. Now, I have the same concern, but mine is slightly different. It is based on a photograph I saw while I was still in college. While I was in college, my best friend was a Muslim named Nabil Qureshi. Nabil showed me some photographs shortly after the September 11th attacks, and I found them quite surprising. Muslims were passing these photographs around and Nabil thought they were absolutely hilarious. The first photograph was a picture of George W. Bush as a Muslim, and I have to admit that was actually pretty funny. The second photograph wasn't so funny, it was a photoshopped picture of the Statue of Liberty covered in a full veil. Now, this one bothered me a little bit. The Statue of Liberty, the symbol of freedom and justice, covered by a full veil, a symbol of oppression and Sharia law. Now these two pictures actually worked their way around the internet and lots of people are familiar with them. The third picture is the one that disturbed me, however. It was a photoshopped picture of New York City covered in mosques and minarets. In the bottom corner it said New York City 2006. The idea was that the terrorist attacks had cleared the ground for the construction of new mosques. David Wood makes some audacious claims that we should take his veritable truth upon his word. First, that the photographs he saw originated with Muslims. Second, Muslims at his college were passing them around, ostensibly in celebration of 9/11. Third, that a burqa is a symbol of Sharia law, and fourth, that the third picture was meant to convey the idea that the terrorist attacks had cleared the ground for the construction of mosques. David Wood must have seen the original post on Joe KS, putting the pictures above into their proper context instead of the misleading context he created. The images weren't designed or disseminated by Muslims after 9/11 as a means of celebrating or dealing with the tragedy through humor. The post that first contained the pictures was lampooning terrorists. The post published in October 2001 was titled "If the Taliban Wins the War Number 1, Number 2, Number 3." David Wood claims that Muslims were passing these pictures around when the truth is they were created by and disseminated by non-Muslims who were making fun of terrorists and extremists. He doesn't provide any evidence of Muslims passing these pictures out. Instead, we are supposed to take him at his word. In reality, it is a clever ploy that omits the fact that not only were Muslims also victims of 9/11, but all major American Muslim organizations condemned the attack in the strongest possible terms. However, he wants to cast Muslims in a dehumanized image. They are not part of our suffering. They are mocking our suffering and enjoy and support 9/11. His disingenuous claim that Muslims mean the third picture to convey the idea that the terrorist attacks had cleared the ground for the construction of mosques is a cynical attempt to link the humor piece deriding the Taliban to the current construction of the Cordoba Cultural Center. He attempts to instill in his watchers the idea that this was the plan all along. In doing so, he asserts the interesting, if off-the-wall conspiracy theory that Osama bin Laden was somehow in cahoots with the founder of the Cordoba Initiative Imam Faisal Abdul Rauf, a Sufi imam who has condemned bin Laden and supported the war in Afghanistan. You see, the plan all along to subvert and take over the West was that bin Laden's goons would fly planes into the Twin Towers. 10 years later, Imam Abdul Rauf, who has never spoken to or met bin Laden, would telepathically, through secret Muslim Taqiyya radar, communicate with bin Laden to receive orders to stealthily build a gigantic 13-story mosque a few blocks away from Ground Zero. Now let's get to the point, David Wood. Cause we are sick of your lies, the devil sleeps in your nose and urinates in your ear. How is this Bible is from God or respecting God? Scientifically is wrong too. If we describe the nature of God based on this passage, what is the description of God that you get from the understanding of this verse? Let's play this out, Christian. Prophet Muhammad states that Muslims should clean their ears and nose because Satan sleeps in the noses of people at night. Bukhari, Volume 4, Book 54, Number 516, and urinates in the ears of people who sleep after sunrise. Bukhari, Volume 4, Book 54, Number 492. Muslim. So, Christian. This is unrealistic, nonsense. Muslim. What's unrealistic and nonsense? Satan or Satan's pee? Christian. I believe Satan is real. But Satan's pee? Come on, Muslim. All religions believe Satan or devil is real. You can't see Satan, can you? How do you expect to see Satan's pee, then? Prophet Muhammad says, Satan reaches everywhere in the human body as blood reaches it, everywhere in one's body. Bukhari 20:35. Christian. Okay, but how would you convince an atheist to believe that Satan sleeps in the noses of people at night and urinates in the ears of people who sleep after sunrise? Muslim. Good question. Atheists don't believe Satan exists, let alone Satan's piss. I would suggest atheists to read my blog named Prove to Me That God Exists. Once they believe God exists, they would also believe that genies exist. Satan is a genie. Almighty Allah is the highest and most knowledgeable, and the attribution of knowledge to him is the safest. Arrogance is not only a sign of insecurity, but also a sign of immaturity. Mature and fully realized persons can get their points across, even emphatically without demeaning or intimidating others. How is this Bible is from God or respecting God? Scientifically is wrong too. If we describe the nature of God based on this passage, what is the description of God that you get from the understanding of this verse? 34. Narrated Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, Allah's messenger, peace and blessings of Allah exalted he upon him, said, when one of you wakes up from his sleep, he must clean his nose with water by sniffling it in and then blowing it out three times, for Satan spends the night inside one's nostrils. Agreed upon, Satan spending the night inside the nostrils of a man is plausible. However, its actual state is better known to Allah. It may be that this is a figurative expression, because bad excretions gather in the nose and cause laziness, indolence, slackness, and negligence. And all these states are satanic dispositions. Blowing water out of the nose upon awakening from sleep might be performed as an individual act, or along with ablution. It is considered obligatory by Ahmad, while the majority of scholars consider it sunnah. Bulla al-Maram, collection of hadith by al-Hafi ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. With brief notes from the book Subul as-Salam written by Muhammad bin Ismail al-Sanani. English Publication Book 1, Hadith 34, Dar es Salaam Publishers.